Hey guys, for today's video, I'm going to be talking about Kimimoto Kagiya, the leader of the Sound 5 and was once next in line to be a candidate vessel for Orochimaru, second only to Gurren and Sasuke. And you might have peeped his white hair and the two dots on his forehead, resembling that of Kaguya Otsutsuki herself, that and his last name being Kaguya. Kimimaro was the sole survivor of the Kaguya clan. Kimimaro was the only member in his clan to inherit the Shikotsuyaku Kekkeigenkai, in generations, translating to Dead Bone Pulse, which allows the select few Kaguya clan members to manipulate their bone and skeletal structure. The same ability possessed by Kaguya herself, Kimimaro being the last to possess the ability of the clan. The patriarch of the Kaguya clan feared a child Kimimaro and his abilities, and thus had him locked away in a cage unless he was needed for battle. His clan was eventually wiped out, and Kimimaro was eventually found wandering by Orochimaru. Not too long after, Kimimaro met a rampaging Jugo, and Kimimaro managed to subdue his rampages and building a friendship with Jugo, which soon led to Orochimaru experimenting on Kimimaro and bestowed upon him the Earth Seal Curse Mark. Kimimaro single-handedly defeated the Sound 4, becoming its leader, and was stated by Kabuto the only reason they lost the battle in the Konoha invasion was because Kimimaro was not present. Kimimaro also aided in the assassination of Gaara's father, the fourth Kazekage. Unlike the barbarian nature of the Kaguya clan, Kimimaro did not have any particular interest in fighting, and actually was quite quiet and gentle. Kimimaro was characterized for his pale skin, white hair, and vivid green eyes. Kimimaro was noted by Orochimaru and Kabuto as the most powerful member of the Kaguya clan, even as a child, and his combat skills outclassed by little to no one. Shikotsuyaku Kekkeigenkai allows him to manipulate the osteoclast cells, giving him absolute control over the concentration of calcium within his bones, allowing him to control the density and malleability, and being able to create an entire forest of gigantic bones that resemble blades, and merge his body with the bones and travel from bone to bone, kind of like a network, almost like a teleportation jutsu. However, the downside of his Kekkeigenkai was his body was structured completely different than any normal or regular human, thus little could be done to fix his chronic illness. Going up against the Nine Tails Chakra Enhanced Naruto, Rock Lee, and backing Gaara into a corner, it's tough to say where Kimimaro ranked power scale wise, and he was definitely one of the more fascinating characters in the Naruto, along with his backstory. Well, that's it for today's video. Comment below, what do you guys think about Kimimaro and his Kekkeigenkai, and what do you think he would rank in the Naruto, even in Naruto Shippuden? That marks it for today's video. Make sure you give this video a big fat thumbs up, like the video, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, join my Patreon and Discord, and all of my other social media platforms are in the link description below, and I will see you in the next video. Bye. Hey guys, just doing a quick little video letting you guys know that I have an updated Patreon account. You can click on any of my YouTube videos to find it out. I have the Haruno clan donation for $2 a month, the Uzumaki clan donation for $5 a month, and the Hyuga clan for $10 a month with all the amenities and everything else. And I also have the Uchiha clan for $15, the Akatsuki for $50, and then the Otsutsuki clan for $100. Everything is included on it. You can also go check out my Discord. I just got a Discord. Click on any of the links in any of my YouTube videos and you'll find my Discord along with Patreon and all of my other social media accounts. And again, if you haven't, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel, everything at Jacob Tutu, and that's it.